We're going to talk about solving what are called absolute value inequalities. So first of all, this is an example of an absolute value inequality. Why? Well, because it's an inequality that contains an absolute value. So let's do this example, but before that, I want to just talk about an idea with you. Let's say that you had the following situation. You were told that the absolute value of something is less than 4. Okay, now I would like to ask you, what can be put in here? Okay, so what could I possibly have in there that would make this statement true? For example, could I have the number 6? Well, you know, if you put 6 in here, is it true? No, because the absolute value of 6 is 6, which is not less than 4, okay? So 6 won't work. What if you try 5? Well, no, for the same reason, right? The absolute value of 5 is 5, which is not less than 4. So we can forget about 5. What about 4? Well, close, but no, right? Because the absolute value of 4 is 4, and 4 is equal to 4, not less than 4. So no on 4. How about 3? Now, that's a yes, right? Because the absolute value of 3 is 3, which is less than 4. So we have a yes on 3. And likewise, we have a yes on 2. And keep going, right, in this fashion. Now, what happens if we get to, for example, negative 2? Well, the absolute value of negative 2 is 2, and that's still less than 4. So we have a yes on negative 2. And what about negative 3? Well, the absolute value of negative 3 is 3, again less than 4. How about negative 3.8? Well, that's a yes again, right? Because the absolute value of negative 3.8 is positive 3.8, which again is less than 4. So it's a yes on negative 3.8. What about negative 4? Well, it's a no, because the absolute value of negative 4 is 4, which is not less than 4. So no on negative 4. Okay, and you can see what's going to happen, right? No on negative 5. No on negative 6, and so on. So what does that mean? Well, it means that, you know, that what was in here had to be less than 4. That was the first requirement, right? So 3.8, 3, 2. But that wasn't enough. It had to be less than 4 because, you know, these numbers, you know, negative 5 is less than 4, but why did that not work? Because the numbers we need have to be not only less than 4, they have to be at the same time greater than negative 4, right? In other words, less than 4 isn't the only requirement. The number also has to be greater than negative 4, okay? And so that same logic applies here. Now, whatever is right here, right? Whatever's between the absolute value signs, whatever's in there has to be, well, less than 7 and greater than negative 7. And so we write that down. X plus 2 has to be less than 7, well, that's part of it, right? And at the same time, greater than negative 7. Now, when we see this, this really suggests to us correctly that whatever's between the absolute value symbols, the x plus 2 in this case, is really between negative 7 and 7. Okay, that's why we write it this way. So it's very suggestive of the reasoning we used over here, right? Now, once you have it at this stage, it's a double inequality, and we know how to solve these, right? This is a compound inequality. And so we're going to subtract 2 from every side. And that's going to leave us with what? Well, negative 9 is less than x, which is less than 5. Okay? And that means we're looking for x's, right? That is our solution set, is negative 9 to 5. And that would be our answer for this problem. So the key was really in the logic we used over here, right? Realizing that whatever's between the absolute value symbols has to be not only less than 7 and greater than negative 7. It's got to be between negative 7 and 7. Okay, so let's try another absolute value inequality. Okay, so here we're solving the absolute value of x minus 2 is greater than 5. And let's play the same game. Let's go ahead and think about the absolute value of something. Let's try that again. The absolute value of something. Oops. Okay, the absolute value of something, let's have it greater than 3. Okay, so the question we can ask once again is, what are we allowed to put in here? What can go between the absolute value symbols? Well, let's go ahead and try some numbers. How about 5? Well, the absolute value of 5 is 5, and that is greater than 3, right? So it's a yes on 5. And it's also a yes on 4, right? The absolute value of 4 is 4, which is greater than 3. Now, what about 3? Well, it's a no on 3 because the absolute value of 3 is 3, which is not greater than 3. And it's actually a no on 2 as well. And it's a no on 0, for example. And how about like negative 2? Well, no, right? Because the absolute value of negative 2 is 2, which is not greater than 3. And negative 3 is a no again. But now, what if we have like negative 3.5? Well, the absolute value of negative 3.5, that's 3.5. And that is greater than 3. So it's a yes on negative 3.5. And it's now a yes again on negative 4, and a yes on negative 5, and so on. So this situation is just the opposite from the previous problem, right? Whatever is here, well, one of two things will work. Anything greater than 3, that's one possibility, right? But there's a second possibility. Any number less than negative 3. So it's interesting, right? On a number line, either to the right of 3, that'll work, or to the left of negative 3. So coming back to our problem here, this is what we're interested in, right? Where does that have to be? And well, one possibility is that that is to the right of 5. Now, to the right of 5 means greater than 5. So x minus 2 is either greater than 5, but there's another possibility. And we use the word or here. And the reason is because in this situation over here, being to the right of 3, it was either to the right of 3 or to the left of negative 3. Either situation worked. So this is different than the previous problem, right? The previous problem we did on the previous page, two conditions had to be satisfied. We had to be between two numbers. That's not the case here. Either to the right of 3, that's one possibility that works, or to the left of negative 3. So in this case, either to the right of 5 or x minus 2 is to the left of negative 5, right? Now, how do we write that? What does it mean to be to the left of negative 5? That means less than negative 5. Really concentrate on this part. This is where people get a little confused. Just remember on it, try to visualize it in your mind's eye on a number line. To the right of 5 on the number line or to the left of negative 5. Do you see it in your mind's eye? That's kind of the trick on these problems. Okay, now let's solve these. We're going to add 2 to both sides. And so we're going to get, let's see, x is greater than 7. That's one possibility, right? Or if we add 2 here, it's going to be x is less than, well, negative 3. So these are the possibilities, right? Now, what numbers satisfy that? Well, that would be all the numbers from 7 to infinity. That's one possibility. But we also have all these numbers, right? To the left of negative 3. And that's going to be negative infinity to negative 3, right? Because we're to the left of negative 3. And when you have two intervals where there's a gap between the two intervals, we use a little union symbol to indicate that we want all the numbers in this set together with all the numbers in that set. And this would be our answer to the problem. So on these problems, it really matters which direction the inequality symbol is pointing, right? So compare this with the previous problem and you'll see what I mean. Okay, let's try one more. Okay, let's solve the absolute value of x plus 4 is less than negative 3. Now, what I see here, the difference is, that the right-hand side is negative. That's the first difference I note. In the previous problem, the right-hand side was positive, right? Now recall that the absolute value of something, the absolute value of anything, right, is always positive. Always. You can also get zero, but always greater than or equal to zero, right? That's what happens when you take the absolute value of something. You're always going to get something that's positive. That means this, that is the left-hand side, is always positive. And look what the question is asking. It's saying, when is that less than negative 3? Well, wait a minute. If something's always positive, how can it be less than? How can it be to the left of negative 3? It can't be. And that's why in this problem there's no solution. The absolute value of something can never be, well, let's put it this way, is always greater than or equal to zero. So if it's always greater than or equal to zero, how can it be less than negative 3? It can't be. Okay, and you can imagine the other situation, right? Where you had the absolute value of something is greater than a negative. What would the solution set to be in that case? Well, the absolute value of something, let's take an example. So if we were asked to solve, let's say the absolute value of x minus 2 is greater than negative 5. Well, this, again, is always positive, right? Now, always positive means to the right of 0. Well, if it's to the right of 0, then certainly it's always to the right of, it's always greater than negative 5, right? So anything we put in here, we're always going to be, at the end of the day, greater than negative 5, because if it's greater than 0, that is greater than or equal to 0, it's always going to be greater than negative 5. So in this case, the solution set would be all real numbers. And you can write that as an interval as negative infinity to infinity. Okay, that would be our answer to this problem. Okay, so that's how we solve absolute value inequalities.